Oh my god! Oh, see? You just blew that little kid's mind.
That is so cool. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It is me, Sean Tank Top. We're over here at Casa de Tank Top, and we are stuck inside, but that is not going to stop us from doing reactions. I am joined in doing those reactions by the Draces. Say hi, Draces.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
Doing all right.
Doing great.
Yeah. So, today's Saturday? What is today?
I will say it's kind of fun to be kind of back in Bulls Mania. This one is very special to all of us because it's my favorite player, my personal favorite player from the Bulls, and I think that I'm guessing it's probably pretty close to your guys' favorite too, if not your favorite. This is going to be centered on the man, the myth, the legend, and Kim Jong-un's like best buddy.
Oh, I forgot about that. That's a little problematic.
I know. Dennis Rodman, the fucking worm, my favorite dude from this era. Draces, I know that you can't see it, but I'm wearing my Worm 91 Black Bulls jersey that I bought about 4 years ago.
It's like I just knew him as the basketball player that like showed up in the wedding dress, and I was just like, that guy's cool.
Right, like I want to go party with that dude. We're gonna hit play on 1, 2, 3 Worm. Sound good?
Sounds good.
1, 2, 3 Worm. I always love it when you see, like, the they have to put it in big, bold letters, mature language, and I'm like, oh, yay!
I like that they did that, though, because, like, you hear, like Jordan, like, trash-talking and be like, motherfucker!
Oh, yeah, I love
it.
Yeah,
we need that audio.
To count how many different hair colors he'll have throughout this episode.
You hear about many things about Dennis Rodman. If you take me away from his team, do you still win a championship? I don't think so. I'm going to go out there and do all the dirty work, take out a beast from other players.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
I want to go out there and get my nose broke. I want to go out there and get cut. The pain. I want to feel that.
Woo! That is awesome. Very punk rock kind of like aesthetic.
I'm on those periods and I'm bored as hell. I got to find some way to
Oh, hey, that's where the Miller Lite, that's where the Miller Lite box came from. Did you guys see the Miller Lite thing in his hand?
No,
you see the can in his hand?
No.
Oh, my God.
Most of the time, though, I see the shit you do.
Oh, man. That ref is talking. That ref is fearless, man. Off and running.
There you go. In his stand.
I remember that shit.
Yeah. I love that shit so hard. Oh my God. Look at those ears.
Oh.
Want to play for us? All right, great.
God, you just like, all right, sure.
Whatever. Yeah, sure, whatever.
Like he would say, man, you don't know life till you can just go out, get away from everybody, get the stars.
Oh, I feel
like too bad.
My sense of Dennis Rodman in his soul, he seems like a little bit like hippie-ish.
Oh, for sure.
Like he has a tarot deck and he's like, he does witchy shit.
Here, click and go that way. Boom, that way. Click here and go like this way.
Yeah, or there's definitely like a hippie-ish kind of weird like savant.
Yeah.
Type of feel that he had that you can kind of you can even tell by the way they're editing his interview. You know what I mean?
Was the fuck up person. He just fucks everything up. Shutting down.
And then Chuck called me over and he said, just leave him alone. You don't put a saddle on a Mustang.
Wow.
Considered a troublemaker on the court in college? Did you have that?
In college?
I built that in Detroit.
And Lambeer and Mahorn, Rodman, Sally, great.
Did you ever play Bill Lambeer's Combat Basketball?
Isaiah Thomas?
On Nintendo?
I remember my buddy had it.
Like, Bill Lambeer used to wear one of those, like, plastic, like face guards so he didn't get his nose broken.
And just, I mean, literally beat people up.
Yeah, seriously. Oh my God.
Wow, it's like hockey.
You like a hockey team.
There you go.
People didn't like it because it was getting away from the beauty of basketball.
Oh, Larry Bird throwing some punches.
Wow.
Yeah, absolutely.
But when you do come to Detroit, you're going to get your ass whooped.
That's funny.
Yeah. It is basically just
okay, that's, we're bad boy. We just start feed into it. Next thing you know, we start to win.
Yeah, they effectively were like the heel in wrestling. Yeah. They like liked being like that notorious for that reason.
This is the Chicago Sports Casino.
Oh boy, here's the gambling.
Oh, there we go. There it is.
Starts.
We know why he wins.
Boy, we're 1-4 against them, and it's on national TV, and I want to beat those guys on Sunday.
That's sick. I wonder what he said that got bleeped, and everything else is not bleeped.
The Bulls had.
Oh yeah, right. What the fuck? Like everything else has been. Yeah,
why was that bleeped?
What's he doing there?
Footage from TV.
Oh.
I'm not gonna let you lose your first game.
Like Doug looks like a bad guy in like RoboCop.
Yeah, he looks like Emilio Estevez's makeover in Mighty Ducks 2.
A little bit, right. A little bit.
He's to whip out a gigantic cell phone and be yelling into it.
Uh-huh.
Could you come here a second so we can kiss on TV?
There we go.
Would you tell him everything is fine?
His slam dunk faces are the best.
he looks like a guitarist, like when they're soloing, kinda.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Where it's like they're kind of face thinking, like, oh fuck yeah, dude! We're getting down with 89 Batman.
I know. I was like, it's kind of a strange choice.
I love it.
Into it.
Gentlemen, let's broaden our minds. It'd be hilarious if Jordan and everybody just started fucking up like a museum. like an art museum. Ooh, look, it's 5G. 5G is coming to give us all COVID.
Oh, dang it.
We took care of you. And he looks at Kent and he says, we took care of you. And he looks at me and we take care of you today.
Elo on MJ. And I'm like, yeah, okay. Whatever. Fuck this bullshit.
This is it. This is the classic one. Yep.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's like the classic.
Shot. Go home, motherfuckers. Go home. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fucking anywhere but get out of here. Whoever's not with us, all you fucking.
That's another one. Hey, Morgan, is that another one that we banked for the Space Jam mashup?
Whoever's not. How high can this is so 80s. Fly? I love it. Michael Jordan
is soaring. Oh my god, yeah, absolutely. It's like, how high can this man fly?
A little team in Detroit who just messed up the whole story. Love that. Oh, I hated him. And yeah, he carries even to this day.
Oh my god.
They made it personal. They physically beat the shit out of us.
Jordan, steal. He kept it in bounds. Here it is again. Oh, wow. Oh, he just like, just saw it in the eye. Just like, nah, I'm just going to go around you. Like,
he can make these like split decisions in like mid-flight. They're going to get so ruthless. Jordan,
you have to stop him before he takes flight. Because, you know, he's not human.
He's not human.
That's when Lambert and Mahorn would go up and knock him down to the ground.
Oh, God. I don't think that they interview Lambert. He's still around and alive. I think I'm pretty sure Jordan was like, fuck this guy. Like,
I could compare Michael Jordan to nobody because for him to survive that and still maintain that greatness, I mean, it's very unparalleled.
And then Demolition Man comes out and he changes his hair color.
That's me, that's Dennis Rodman. I'm not trying to please anybody.
And then Madonna goes, he's cute. And they started seeing each other.
Oh, I remember that.
Yeah.
So good.
Explain to be who they tell you should be.
Ooh, so Madonna was like, go for it.
Yeah, I mean,
well, it's like this.
He looks fucking hot there, though. Like, you know, I could see that. My Madonna was like into it.
I remember watching this fucking interview. Oh my god!
I'm doing what I'm doing.
Yeah.
It's making me happy. It makes me feel like I'm a 10-year-old kid.
Aww.
I've been pretty much lazy and just hell.
Ah.
There we go.
Amazing.
Do you remember your first meeting with Rodman?
That was awful. I walk into. Got a pool boy hat over his eyes, got the rings in his nose.
With the
his
old,
mouth.
With the super round Oakleys,
he
right?
Up. He said, "Then you want to come play for the Bulls?" I said, "I don't care, whatever."
I love it.
That's what he did.
There you go. That, oh my God! Just like.
Oh man.
Knows how to play his role well.
Getting trounced by fucking Rodman.
Terrifying.
Like on the sideline. That was like Gallagher smashing a watermelon in your face. Like people wanted it to happen. He's just a fucking rock star.
He has like, I mean, he always had like the an artist soul, like that hippie artist.
There's Gus Sniff, CT Sniff, Calvin Sniff.
All the sniffs.
Sniff brothers, hey, take care of Michael over here. Sniff
brothers are Michael's security guys. Brother is
look at this Chicago ass motherfucker. Holy shit.
Michael's jock, so all these guys would always be around.
He's the general sniff right here.
Thank you so much. Aww. Oh my God! You just blew that little kid's mind.
That is so cool.
Thank you so much.
No, no. I've been in Nashville, brother.
Bulls forward suited up at the United Center tonight and took.
I do remember. I was so fucking happy when he came back. Ah, look at that. He's got the old leopard.
Those are 33s in tribute to Pippen's return.
Oh my God, I love watching shit like this.
I'm pretty much the third wheel of the family.
Oh,
Rodman.
Oh, this person kissed my ass. I don't give a damn what they think about me.
Oh, so cool.
Everybody understood Dennis.
While Scotty was out, Dennis was a model citizen.
To a point where it was driving him fucking insane.
Just wanted to take a vacation.
I come to practice, Phil calls me and says,
I need to go to Vegas.
Phil, you let this dude go to vacation, we're not going to see him. You let him go to Vegas, we definitely
he gone.
Can your vacation be like 48 hours? And Dennis is like,
I got no other choice. I take whatever you can give me, I take the 48 hours.
You ain't going to get that dude back in 48 hours.
I went to the fucking Vegas.
Look at this dude drinking and driving this fucking motorcycle.
Bizarre, but I think what made
oh man.
Was Phil and Mike, you had to give him some
I mean,
some
it's
rope.
A Miller Lite and he's 20 and, feet tall, so.
No. Yeah, I mean, probably just having one beer. You know.
But still, that's bold. That's bold to be chugging beer and getting on a motorcycle in front of all those cameras.
Uh-huh. Yeah, he didn't give a shit
today.
Ah,
yeah.
There we go. I think the next one is when they basically they have to like get him back. They have to pull him out of
there. Did they send an extraction team?
It's like it's a one story element that I didn't know before that I heard from like online shit or whatever, and it involves Carmen Electra. So.
Oh my God! Yeah, this.
I'm so excited. This is gonna be great.
I want this movie. I want an entire
I mean, like,
heist movie where it's like, here, I'm arming you with a fuck ton of money to pay off whoever you need to pay off. Go to Vegas, find Rodman, and you have to do it in 10 hours. You have 10 hours to get him back.
No. You get the Sniff brothers. He sends like two of the Sniff brothers to go get him.
Well, we're gonna recast them as attractive people.
They'll be fucking played by fucking Matthew McConaughey and Channing Tatum with fucking Chicago accents. Yeah. Oh my God, that's the one thing you gotta talk to them about is that time is a flat circle. Let me tell you right now, you know, like.